Nice to meet you. Hey, Kelly, how are you?
I'm all right.
Kelly, where are you from?
I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
I like it.
Thank you very much. Cool. Also, I'm from UCLA, so you may have
I went to grad school at SC, I don't care much. I like UCLA. A lot of good filmmakers come out of there.
Yeah, but that's what I like to hear. So.
I got no rivalries.
How are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
The Express. You are the king, I would say, the king of thrill and suspense.
Okay.
The Express came across your table. Why did you pick this film? What did it do? How did it speak to you as a filmmaker and as a person?
Like any director, you're looking for a great story to tell. I mean, films are, it sounds cliche, but you're telling a story. Mm-hmm. And Ernie Davis' story to me is one of the great stories I've ever come across in my own career so far. It was just an amazing story, and I couldn't believe I didn't know it. Mm-hmm. I couldn't believe it was true, and no one that I knew the story. Mm-hmm. And there are many reasons for that, but I mean, ultimately, my thing was, wow, what a great way to sort of change it up. I also happen to like sports movies. Yeah. You know, I love Friday Night Lights and The Longest Yard, the first one. you know, and Any Given Sunday, and I just, you know, I love good sports movies. Mm-hmm. You know, Hoosiers, The Natural. And I wanted to take my shot at doing one.
Yeah.
And so there was an intimidation factor of not having done one, mm-hmm. but the idea of sort of branching out as a filmmaker and telling a story that I hadn't told before, I thought was great fun.
Definitely, definitely. Now, question, it's based on a true story. Now, as a filmmaker, we've been kind of saturated with Hollywood with a lot of remakes and a lot of, you know, big budget films, you know, and they do have their place. But, you know, for me, you know, a true story speaks to me as a person, you know. Did it speak to you? And how do you feel about, true story versus, you know, remakes?
Well, if you can have a story as compelling as The Express or Ernie Davis' story and have it be true. I mean, the thing that really, I think, really affected people in the screenings, and it was so true, is that when they saw at the end, the card comes up, and they realize it was a real guy, mm-hmm. and they see the footage at the end of the real Ernie Davis, and it lands on them that they're watching a story that we didn't just make this up. It wasn't just sort of a Forrest Gump fiction.
Yeah.
They're knocked out by it, and so was I.
Yeah.
You know, and so was I. Meeting with Jim Brown, mm-hmm. it was really helpful for me as a storyteller. I mean, meeting with Jim Brown, saying to him, you knew Ernie Davis, you were there before him mm-hmm. at Syracuse, you knew this coach, tell me about those times. Mm-hmm. And Jim Brown, who's a real guy, took me inside to this world, you know, and became a consultant on the movie and then saw the movie at the end and gave me his thumbs up. So, I mean, without Jim Brown's involvement, I think this film couldn't have been made, at least by me.
When it comes down to making a film, and especially in a film like this, you want to be truthful and you want to be honest, mm-hmm. especially about those days and the time and mm-hmm. the you know, when it took place. Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you know, with Jim Brown help, do you feel that you was able to you know, capture the realness and you know, the racial tension that was back in that time and the mm-hmm. bigotry and, you know.
Well, I always went back to you know, getting a lot of research and try to triangulate what the truth is, mm-hmm. because even the research, sort of like people's memories, it can be different, it can be disparate. I think you have to sometimes say, read 10 different articles about a certain event mm-hmm. and figure out, like, what's the truth in between. And by the way, you can have two people at the same dinner who remember it differently.
Yeah.
And that's, it makes you nuts, especially when you go through the research. And so listen, Jim Brown has his point of view, and some journalists have their point of view, what really happened. And sometimes you look at footage of a game, and it might not coincide with their memory of what really happened. So I think we got it right. I mean, listen, I showed the film to Jim Brown a few months ago, and Jim Brown looked at me and he said, "You got it right." So I said to him, "I got your thumbs up. I'm good to go."
Yeah, it made you feel good. I know it did.